In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to use wattmeter, how it works, and how to take readings when you are doing experiments. So if you look at this wattmeter, there are several terminals. On top you have three terminals, here also so many terminals. So at the first glance, it appears to be a bit complicated. So you need to pay attention on how to use it. Now let's try to understand how a wattmeter works. So for working of wattmeter, it needs voltage and current information. So to get that, the arrangement that we are making is we are having fixed coil which is connected in series with the load. So you get load current directly, and one set of coil is connected across the load to get the voltage information. So this is the current carrying coil. It's known as CC or current coil. It is two terminal. One is M for mains, because it is connected to the supply main side, and the other side is L, which is connected to the load side. So this L denotes load. So this current coil measures the current of the load, and to get indication of the voltage across load, we are connecting one more coil. So this coil is known as the pressure coil. Now if you just connect this pressure coil across the load, it will draw very high amount of current depending on the voltage magnitude. So to prevent high current, we are putting one high value resistance in series with that pressure coil. Now this pressure coil is giving an indication of the voltage in terms of the current flowing through the coil. So we have two coils in which we have load current information as well as load voltage information. So from that, how we are going to get the power information? So this current carrying coil is kept in a fixed kind of arrangement. So as you can see, this two forms the current coil. Now as some current is flowing through it, let's say we are sending positive current. So following this path, we'll have an electromagnet created. So this side will be N, this side will be S as per the current direction, and here also this side will be N, this side will be S. And if I apply positive voltage across these two terminals, so let's say we are having a positive current flowing through it. So again, as per the arrow direction, we'll have N this side and S this side. So these two will repel, and as a result, the indicator will try to reflect on the right side. And if I have a positive current here and a negative current flowing through the pressure coil, then this will try to reflect on the left side. So depending on current directions, you will have the overall deflection or overall resultant your reading that we can achieve. So for DC kind of application, both the current will be positive, and as a result you will get an positive deflection. But in case of AC, if it is a purely resistive load, then voltage and current both will be in the same phase. As a result, it is pretty easy to understand. But in case of some reactive kind of load, so for some duration, one current will be positive and another current will be negative. So it will try to deflect on the left side, and for the other part, both the current will be in positive. So they will try to reflect in the right direction, but there will be an average value of deflection which is coming out of both positive and negative interaction. So for example, if you have an inductive kind of load, so for half of the time both the current will be in different direction, and half time they will be on the same direction, but their resultant deflection will be zero because both of them will be trying to rotate in the opposite direction for the same amount of time with same strength. So as a result, your wattmeter will give you zero reading. So this is how wattmeter knows about this power factor information. So wattmeter doesn't measure power factor directly, it is actually measuring the average value of the power. Now we'll try to see how to make this wattmeter connection and how to read its value so that we get proper power measurement. So we'll follow this circuit arrangement. We have the AC supply at the left hand side, and this is the load across which we are going to measure the power. So as of now, I'm just using a simple rheostat here, and this is how we have to make the connection. So MLCV we have to connect. So let's try to understand where is this MLCV. So if I zoom in, what you can see is that this is the M terminal, this is the L terminal, and this is the common terminal, which is C. So you have got these three already available to you, C, M and L. So these three terminals are sorted. Now for the voltage, what we are going to see is that we have three ranges available to us. So as you have seen how voltmeter works, it may have two or three ranges. So in wattmeter also, for voltage measurement, we have three range available. So based on your requirement, you will be connecting to one of them. And for the current also, we have two range available here. So in the display we can see it is 2.5 and 5. So how we are going to select that? We are going to select it by making proper connection in this terminals. Now I'm going to show you how to adjust this position so that you can select either 2.5 scale or 5 ampere scale. So the position right now it is having, as you can see, this is for 2.5 ampere scale, and now I'm going to show you how to change it to 5 ampere scale. So we'll be playing with these knobs and let's see how to do it. So basically we'll be connecting two internal coils in parallel so that the overall current rating can be increased. So as you can see how to do it. So this is how now we have connected it for 5 ampere scale, and now again we'll be connecting it back to 2.5 ampere scale so that this entire process is very clear to you. So this setting is for 2.5 ampere scale. Now for the current, as you have understood, we have two different scale, and for the voltage we have three more scales. One is this 75, another is 150, and another is 300. So if we select one from voltage and one from the current scale, there are six combinations. Now if we want to make six scales, this display will be very clumsy. So we have a single scale, and there is a need to adjust our readings, and we'll take help of a factor called multiplying factor. So based on where we are connecting our scale, based on that we'll be deciding this multiplying factor. Now how to decide this multiplying factor? So if you look at this wattmeter, you will get some reference here. Here you can see current is written over here and voltage scale is written over there. And if you select, let's say, 2.5 ampere scale, and the voltage you select 75, so the multiplying factor will be 1. And if you select, let's say, 5 ampere and 150 volt, so you'll be selecting multiplying factor of 4. How you are going to use it? So let's say we have connected it for 5 ampere scale and 150 volt, and our multiplying factor is 4. So whatever reading we'll be getting from here, we'll multiply it with 4 to get the final reading. Now in case this display is not clear to you, it is not available in the lab, so how do you get this multiplying factor? Whatever current scale you are using and whatever voltage scale you are using, you multiply them together and then divide by the full scale available to you and take the nearest integer, so that will be your multiplying factor. Now let's try to see how to make this wattmeter connection for a simple resistive load and how to complete one set of readings. So as you have understood, we have the power supply here and we have a rheostat here, which is this rheostat, and we are going to connect this wattmeter using this terminology M, L, C and V. So if we start from the left hand side, I'm taking power supply from a variac, right? So variac, this plus side, this side on the top side will be connecting to the M. So let's see how it is done. So we are taking this wire and we are connecting it to M. So this is M, this wire is going to M, and from M we are taking one short wire and we are connecting it to the common. So we basically we are making this connection, M and C are to be shorted. And from the L terminal, we have to connect to the load. So what we are doing is that this is the L terminal. So one wire is going to the load. Now before it is going to the load, I have just included an multimeter in between so that the current I can see. So the difference you can see between multimeter in for voltage measurement and current measurement, this multimeter is set for voltage measurement. So this is the common probe, and see, for voltage measurement I have inserted the probe here, but for the current measurement I have inserted the probe on the left hand side where A is written. So this is actually giving me the voltage rating, and I have set this here for voltage measurement, and this I have set for current measurement. So this is how you can use an multimeter for measuring voltage and current. Now as we know, whatever instrument we are using for current measurement, we have to keep in series. So from L terminal, we are taking to one of the probe, and through ammeter, the other part is coming to your rheostat. So basically this multimeter is connected in series with the rheostat as we make connection for ammeters. And from other part of the rheostat, we will be connecting it back to the supply, which is this connection. So this connection is back to the supply, and where we are going to connect this V. So as you know, V is actually the other terminal for the pressure coil. So we'll be connecting it to the this anywhere here, either here or on the this part of your supply. So we have connected it here on the supply. So this is going to V. Now where we have connected it, we have connected it to 150 scale. So this is the midpoint. This is actually 150, and the current we have kept for 5 ampere scale. So as you can see, the way we have connected, it is for 5 ampere and the voltage is for 150 volt. Now what is the reading coming to the wattmeter? So we'll position ourselves so that these two deflections are same, and you can see we have around 6 divisions. So between 0 to 20 we have total 10 division. So each division is 2, and the pointer is at 6th division now. So 6 into 2 is 12. And what is the multiplying factor? Multiplying factor is 4, because current is 5, voltage is how much? 150. So their multiplication is giving me 750. So 750 by 200, and what will be its nearest integer? It will be 4. And how can you be sure? If it is, let's see what is written over there. So we are using 5 ampere scale and 150 volt scale. So my multiplying factor is 4. So if you remember, we had total 6 divisions, 6 into 2, because per division it was 2 volt. Per division it was 2 value. So 6 into 2 is 12, and then multiplying factor 4. So it is 48 watt. So we have voltage at 50, current at 1, so that means power is 50 watt. So from this we are getting power approximately 50 watt, from here we are getting it is 48 watt. Now let's see, if we connect an inductor, what will be the wattmeter reading. So here we have just in this part we have connected an inductor, and let's see what is the voltage and current reading. So voltage we are having 20 and current is almost 2, so their product is 40, and let's see what is the reading on the wattmeter. So as you can see, the wattmeter is on almost 1 division. So 1 division value is 2 and multiplying factor is 4, so almost we are having 8 watt. So ideally this should have been 0 watt, But as you know, an inductor, it is not ideal. There is some parasitic resistance involved. In the coil, we'll have some resistance. In the core, we'll having some core loss. So those loss are reflecting here. Now we'll try to observe what is the wattmeter reading when we have connected only capacitor load. Across the capacitor, we have 45 volt and 1 ampere current is flowing through the capacitor. And now let's try to see what is the reading on wattmeter. Just half division. So half division, this value will be 1. And what is the multiplying factor? It is 4. So 1 and 4, it is 4 watt. Now ideally, the power measured across the capacitor should have been 0. But as we know, they are not very ideal. Might be being some losses in them. So those losses getting reflected in the wattmeter.